You're up front on ENCA. Cristin Flynn is an endurance athlete of note and now takes on the challenge of becoming the first woman to circumnavigate the globe on a bicycle in record time. The current record holder is a Scottish woman, and she smashed the same goal in just 124 days and 11 hours. She beat the previous record holder by 20 days. So take a look at this, and then we'll have a conversation with Cristin.
On an epic quest, you, me, all of us. Truth is, if we could see the distance each of us has already covered, the hardships we've weathered, the climbs we've conquered, the downhills that have both thrilled and threatened us, the dangers we've averted, the traps that have held us for a time before we eventually broke free to continue our quest as we saw it, we would stand in awe of each other. For me, the biggest struggle.
So let's hear it from Cristin Flynn herself. She's here to tell us what the target is. So the record 124 days and 11 hours around the globe. What are you aiming for and why?
I plan to do it in under 120. So that's the goal. It's a 29,000 kilometer journey. Mm. So I'll be looking at doing about 220 to 240 kilometers a day.
Sure. Have you even mapped out in your head what the journey looks like? Where do you start? Do you do the African continent first?
No. I start in Germany. Africa is unfortunately a little bit too, our roads are a little bit lumpy and bumpy. And the previous record holders have done through Germany towards China, Australia, New Zealand, and back through the States and end at Germany. That's sort of what's worked for them, and I've looked at what they've done, and I'm pretty much going to follow what they've done.
Right. So why are you doing this, Cristin?
Many reasons. There's a charitable aspect. I'm wanting to raise funds and awareness for a little school in East London. It's the African Angels, so that's a very big part of my heart. Then it's also just to communicate to people that they really need to go out and do what is in their heart to do. This has been something that's been, something that I've wanted to do for decades.
Yeah.
And it's the time now for me to do that.
And I believe part of your cause is about raising awareness around issues to do with mental health, right? We have a big mental health issue in this country. From time to time, you hear people saying, one day we must have the conversation, one day we must.
Yes.
But that one day is now, is it?
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, I've really struggled with this from childhood. And sports has been something that has helped me. So there'll be a lot of conversation around that in the sort of build-up and afterwards.
How do you even prepare for such a journey? What are you doing now?
Well, I actually just cycled in from East London. I left on Monday and I arrived in Johannesburg about an hour and a half.
Oh, yeah?
Yes.
So how are your legs feeling?
They're feeling fantastic. I'm actually feeling
from
very
East
strong.
London?
Yes. So I did about 200 kilometers a day. I have been doing this for many years. It's not something that I've just started doing. I would just go on little adventures for a week or two here and there and just go across country, and I just love it.
Yeah. So what kind of challenges do you anticipate along this journey?
I battle with hydration, so there are large or big areas where, you don't have access to water necessarily, and I'm probably going to be doing this unsupported, although if I can raise sort of more funds, then I will have a support vehicle come with me. But at this stage, it's looking like I'll be doing it unsupported.
That's daunting, isn't it, if you have to do it unsupported?
Well, I'm doing unsupported riding through Africa at the moment. So I think up in Europe and, those areas, it might be a bit easier. I have got some experience because I did live in the UK for a few years.
So how do people support your cause?
Well, I have a website. There's information on there. I'm looking for sponsors. I'm also looking for an investor or investors who would be interested in documenting this. So I'm really wanting to do a documentary. I think it would be a bit of a shame to go out there and cycle for four whole months and not capture it. It's just such a beautiful experience.
Yeah, and I wonder if you are able to even anticipate how this whole experience will change you as a person.
Well, yes.
It's kind of hard.
The build-up already has been life-changing, and I'm learning lessons along the way. And one thing that I really learn every single day is how good and kind people are. Because as I've been doing this unsupported, I've really had to rely on the kindness of all kinds of South Africans, from very poor people in townships asking them for water or, you know, something to eat because I've run out, and there have been big stretches of maybe 100 kilometers without a shop. To the very wealthy, all kinds of South Africans, all races, and you know, they've just been amazing.
Are you going to cycle back to Island? Are you going to take your bicycle
from Johannesburg? I'm going to KZN. There's an investor there who I'm going to see. And from KZN, I'll be cycling to East London.
All right. Are you cycling to KZN?
Cycling to KZN.
And then to East London.
Cycling to East London.
Cristin, how many days to go? I saw that you have a countdown that you've already started.
Goodness.
About 140 thereabouts.
148.
Yeah.
Yes.
All right, Cristin Flynn, all of the best.
We
will
very much
touch base with you at
Lovely.
Some point, I believe, so
Great.
That we can track where you are cycling there for a cause around the globe.
Wonderful.
That's Cristin Flynn there talking to us about the epic journey that she's about to undertake of circumnavigating the globe on a bicycle. I wonder if is that the proper phrasing? Well, she'll be cycling around the world.